As we introduced a brand new way to organize the workflow of our inspections, switching from flight base to workspaces, we needed to update the cockpit app consequentially. While the flying part remained basically untouched, there are now some additional steps to go through before the arming of the drone. Once cockpit has been updated, turn on your Helios 3, connect the tablet to the RC, and wait for the Helios 3 to connect to the cockpit application. Now click on Inspect. In the inspection planning panel that opens, you will be asked to select a previously created asset or to create a new asset. This will allow you to store all the inspections you do in an asset in a single folder and visualize points of interest recorded in previous flights while flying. Once you have selected the asset you are inspecting, on the right side of the screen, click on the inspection if you want to continue or create a new inspection. An inspection will no longer be a single flight, but rather a combination of different flights within an asset automatically aligned by asset management software. You will then be given the option to do a mapping flight, an inspection flight, or a handheld mapping. If it is your first flight, a pop-up window will open and tell you that you'll need to scan thoroughly the starting area to create a baseline around the takeoff point for all the other flights. After the takeoff, gain a couple of meters of altitude and do a 360-degree maneuver. Once landed, you have the option to save the flight or delete it in case you messed up the mapping. When conducting two or more flights in the same inspection to allow the software to align flights, please remember to click on their localized slider over the inspection type. Choose your inspection type. As you can see, the point cloud from the flight before and the new one are not aligned. Now cockpit will then ask you to perform a manual relocalizations. So pick up the drone and rotate it manually by 360 degrees over 1 or 2 meters, taking into account the dead angles of the sensor. Once this is done, place it again on the ground and click on their localize button. Remember that the drone needs to start at the same takeoff place for all flights. If the process was done correctly, you will have a visual confirmation and the two-point clouds will align automatically. If not, you will get an error and you need to start the manual maneuver again. Once relocalization is done, the airlock indicator on the upper right side of the screen will be green. You can resume your flights. The map you have scanned previously will be in white, while the point cloud you are creating now will be in color. Once the flights are saved, you can visualize them in the left part of the screen in the inspection dashboard. Here you can hide or show POIEs and previous maps by toggling them on or off.